giving a presentation on the LL1 parser and explaining its construction by the help of an example. So giving a brief introduction of LL1 parsing, it is a top-down parsing method that takes place in the syntax analysis phase of a compiler. A LL1 parser will accept a grammar G if there are two distinct productions. Also, LL1 uses input buffer, stack, and parsing table for storing its data. So the construction of any predictive LL1 parser is usually conducted in four steps, that is creating the first and follow, then the parsing table, then stack implementation, and then we can just parse any input string to see if it follows the LL1 grammar or not. Okay. So here we have taken an example to see how the LL1 parsing works. So here we have a grammar where S determines A, A determines AB and AD, and B produces B and C produces G. So now that we can see that the grammar is left recursive, we first need to remove it from the grammar. Okay. So here we have a new set of rules with an extra production A dash. And now we can easily calculate the first and follow functions for the same. Now here we are finding the first of all the non-terminals. So at first, we have this first of S here, which will give me again a non-terminal A. So again, finding the first of A gives me small a. Now for A dash, we have two productions. Hence, D and epsilon will be the first of A dash here. Similarly, for B and C, the respective first will be B and G. Now moving to the calculation of the follow function. So the follow of S will be, since the S here is the starting symbol, so its follow will always be dollar symbol, which we'll use in the referencing of the stack in the later slides. Now for the follow of A, now since the follow, since for follow we always check the right hand side, since there is no terminal, it will first shift back to S, that is on the left side, and then we will have to calculate the follow of S, and that we already know is dollar, okay. Then for same for the A dash, it will go back to A, and then we have follow of A, which is again dollar. Now for finding the follow of B, it's a slightly different approach. Here, B is succeeded by another non-terminal A dash. So we need to check the production of A dash as well. And as we see that it has two distinct productions and one of them is epsilon here. Now, if we didn't have an epsilon, then only we could have just written the first of A dash and that's it. But since it contains an epsilon, we need to eliminate it and then union it with the follow of A. So as we all know that follow should not contain any epsilon. So we have to eliminate. Thus, the follow of B is D, epsilon. Now for the C, there is no terminal on the right hand side, so it is not accepted. Now we have again written the production rules against their first and follow, and you will use this to implement the stack and the parse tree.
We are coming to the second stage. Here we need to construct the parse table for the given production. So first we can see that we have columns as the terminals and rows as the non-terminals. Now coming to the first grid, we have placed as determines A. This is because first of this production gives us the value A. Hence as to A is under A terminal. And again seeing the first functions, we have filled other productions in this respective position. Also for production A dash, we have two values in its function. Hence we have implemented them separately. Okay. So now for the epsilon value, it is placed under dollar. So this is our parse table for the given grammar. And now we will move to the stack implementation. So for the stack implementation, we have taken an input string that is ABD dollar. So we will start stacking this input with the starting symbol as dollar. So now referring the parse table, we need to see which production is associated with the first element of stack and the input. Here S and A, small a, gives us the production as determines A, capital A. Now since A is non-terminal, we need to replace it with S, which gives us A dollar. Then we write the respective production of A and small a. Now in the next step, we get a terminal A. And now when we replace it with capital A, it matches the first element of input string. So we can pop it out. Now, similarly, the next non-terminal is B. We write its production, then replace it with small b, and later pop it out again. This way, the whole stack becomes empty, where at last we have this epsilon naught, which is nothing but empty string. As the input was successfully passed and accepted by this LL1 grammar. Now, next slide. Now, in this slide, we have simply implemented the parse tree with top-down approach with the help of this stack. So, obviously, when it is a top-down parser, we need to traverse from top to down. And we will start with S until A dash. So, when we look at the nodes containing the terminals, it gives us our input string. So, this was all about LL1 parser and its construction. Thank you.
Yes.
Very good presentation. Yes, here I should also mention that you have already told that epsilon cannot be there. Why epsilon comes here? It should not be this.
Yes, sir. Sir, this was some writing mistake. It will be
It should not be that this epsilon is one mistake, but no issue.
Yes,
no
sir.
Problem.
I so here also I made some mistake. I had written here small a. I rectified that, but for this one I did not see.
Yeah, let's go to there. Dollar cannot be there. It should be epsilon. Input character should be dollar cannot be there. I don't know from where you have got it. It should be epsilon.
No, sir. Actually, I had seen one video from there. I got this idea that to put any empty string, we have to put it under the dollar.
Actually, the logic is. Here the column should be all terminals, epsilon can be there, no dollar, and here all the variables, no dollar. Okay. Here I always mentioned you that even my presentation also, please don't put F, you put all first, otherwise people will confuse, first and follow.
Full yes, sir, right. For follow I've written FO, actually there was no space and I had to paste it.
The space because you cannot go sometimes so quickly. So yeah, so that is the reason. Whenever you are showing fast and follow, just a minute, go to the earlier slide, please. Whenever you are doing fast and follow, the rule should be available here. Everything, I think you should appreciate that in my presentation, I try to available everything so that the people can understand the which rule you are talking. That will be better. I think you are smart people that everything should be nullable variable means you put nullable, then you have to take the fast up the nullable. And follow up that variable, intersection should be shy. So that checking you have not done. So whether it's a LL1 parsing, the first thing is all the rules, all the right hand side, for any particular variable you can have multiple rules. The first of all these multiple rules, intersection should be shy. That is rule number one. If any variable goes to epsilon, then first of that variable and follow up that variable, intersection should be shy. So these two things is the first that you have please have not mentioned partly, and another thing is that then you go for parsing table and anyway very good presentation. A book is available. Please take. Thank you, Sneha and Shubham. Now,
okay. Slide. I will discuss about the introduction. That what is top-down parser and two forms and all types. So first is what is top-down parser. The process of constructing the parse tree, which starts from the root and goes down to the leaf, is top-down parsing. Next is top-down parser comes in two forms, that are predictive parsers and backtracking parsers. So predictive parsers predict the production rule to be applied using look-ahead tokens, and backtracking parsers is will try different productions backing up when parse fails. So next is the predictive parser are much faster than backtracking, as predictive parsers operate in linear time and backtracking parsers operate in exponential time. So next slide will represent by Ankita. Thank you, sir.
Good afternoon, I am Ankita, roll number 9113, and I will be discussing the topic construction of LL1 parser for this particular grammar. Now, in LL1, we see that the first L stands for, scanning or rather reading the input from left to right. And the second L stands for using the leftmost derivation for parsing. And one stands for the look ahead count. That is how many variables we are going to read from the leftmost side. So that is one. Now, as we see in this grammar, The step one is removing the left recursion. Now for the production S, there's no left recursion, but for the next production, that is production of L, we see we have L in the leftmost in the leftmost side. So if when we do the leftmost derivation using the parse tree, L will be there at present recursively. For that, we need to remove the left recursion first, and that is done by introducing a new variable, that is L hash. Now we have step two, left factoring the grammar. Now, left factoring means that when there's simultaneous presence of the same variable both on the LHS as well as the first leftmost symbol on the RHS. But in this case, we see that there's no repetition of symbol, on both sides, and on the right side, the leftmost one. So this grammar is already left factored. Now, we'll have the third step, that is finding first and follow sets. Now, for all the variables, we have to find the first and the follow of the variables. Now, I will try to explain the first of L, that is how to find out the first of the variable L. Now, according to the productions, L can actually be expanded to S and L hash. Now, for this S, we see that S variable will be at the leftmost side of when we are expanding L. So, for that reason, we have the first bracket as the first of L, and also A as the first of L, and firsts will always be the terminals, or it may be null. Now, we also need to come to the L hash side, though it is at the right side following S, but still, if L hash becomes null, then we will see that L will only be producing S. So in that case also, for the first of L, we will have first bracket and A as the leftmost symbols. Now, in this way, we have to find the first of all the variables. Then I'll explain how to find the follow of the variable S. Now, for the follow for the variable S, it's the starting variable for the grammar. For that, we have to include the dollar symbol in the follow. Now we see, now we'll find those productions which are having S in the RHS. And we find the first one and the second one. Now these two productions that are present, we see in both the in both of them, L hash is following S. So the first of L hash will be present in the follow of S. So the first of L hash is comma and it is epsilon. So a comma will be placed, not epsilon. Epsilon is not present in follow. Now we see when L hash is substituted as epsilon, we will have L producing only S. So in this case, there's no one following S, or there's no variable or no terminal on the right hand side of S. For that reason, we have to include in the follow of S whatever is the follow of L. And the follow of L will be the closing bracket, so we'll place it in the follow. In this way, we have to find out the follow for all the variables. Now comes the main step, that is how to construct the parser table, or how to make the production entry in the parser table. Now, in the parser table, we have the terminals in the columns and we have the variables in the rows. Now, we'll first see the first and follow table. For example, for the variable S, we see in its first, there is the first bracket and the terminal A. These both are terminals. Now, what we have to do, we have to fill in the productions which are producing these particular terminals in the respective cells. For example, for the variable S, it will be producing this variable, terminal, that is the first bracket, using this production, that is S to first bracket L and closing bracket. So in this similar manner for A also, S producing A, this is the production which is producing A from S, and it's written in this respective cell. Now we see that there's no column for null. So if there's null as the first of a particular variable, that is L hash, what we have to do, we have to place that particular production which is producing null in the follow of that particular variable, that is L hash. So in the follow of L hash, there's closing bracket, and in that closing bracket, it's the null production, the production of L hash which is producing null is written. So in this way, the entire parser table needs to be filled. And we see that in this particular parser table, there's only, the cells which we filled, there are only one production in the respective cells. So this grammar as parser table is possible for this. We can say this grammar is LL1 grammar. Now Rahul will give the conclusion.
Good afternoon, sir. I am Rahul Kumar Gupta. My role is 20127. So now discussing about the topic advantage, disadvantage, and conclusion of the top-down parsing. Advantage of top-down parsing, it does not look at the right context in any systematic way, and its extreme simplicity is also top-down parsing great strength, and it is very easy to figure out what it is doing. And the disadvantage is backtracking, left recursion, left factoring, ambiguity, and problem with ungrammatical sentence. And the conclusion of top-down parsing is parsing steps prediction and scan. Second one is non-deterministic in general, and last one is different control structure. This is all about. Next slide. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Very good presentation. Okita, can you come to the second and third slide, please? Please come to the mic. Yeah. Thank you very much. Okay. The good presentation, but some of the suggestion I shall mention that.
Sir, this is the second slide.
Sir, go for next slide. Yeah. Actually, I always mention about the earlier presentation also. Please always, parts should be all capital letter. Not like this, as your own. Okay, it signifies something. It is better. Okay, and another thing is you also have not shown whether it's nullable or not. So there should be another column here. Like L dash is nullable, and you have to check that first of L dash and follow of L dash. Here you see the first of L dash and follow of L dash is a shy. So please, every now this time onwards for your presentation, always check whether it's nullable or not. First follow, this is okay, and whenever you make this kind of discussion, all these rules should be available in the screen. Otherwise, good. And go to the parsing table, you did also same mistake. I don't know from which book you are getting, dollar should not be there. Fortunately, no entry is there, and like earlier, but dollar should not be there, and epsilon should be there. Because sometimes you need A to epsilon, L dash to epsilon transaction should be needed. So this parsing table is wrong. There should be some epsilon, and L dash to epsilon will be executed at some point in time for certain amount of string. Otherwise, here should be epsilon, and all capital, follow should be capital, nullable.
Thank you, sir.